college hacks that made me feel like a residential student. So this video is specifically for anyone who is interested or wondering if they want to commute, for anyone who is currently a commuter student, or if you're just a student in college in general or about to be, because at majority of colleges, you will probably most likely end up commuting, because when you get older, typically you move off campus and you get an apartment with some people or you share a house together. So I think if you fall into any of those categories, you will very much so benefit from this video. But first, if you're new here, my name is Christina. I post faith-based, lifestyle, and college content. And if those are videos that you enjoy watching, please subscribe. I would love to have you guys a part of the family. So let's talk about it. Commuting to college. I feel like I've gotten this question a lot. Like, should I do it? What are the pros? What are the cons? Can you like compare and contrast? So if you want a pros and con video on commuting versus residential life in college, let me know. Leave a comment down below. But we're gonna be talking about some hacks that made me feel like a residential student when I was driving my butt to college and I didn't have a dorm. But first, I think it's important to know and recognize that there are different types of commuter students. So number one, there's the commuter student that isn't within walking distance. So you may have a house or an apartment right next to your campus and you don't need a drive, or you don't need to like carpool with anybody. You can literally walk. It's within walking distance. Then there's a person who lives probably like 15, maybe 20 minutes away from campus. So your apartment or wherever you live is close by, but it is a little bit of a drive. Nothing crazy, but things that you have to factor in are traffic and whatnot. And then there is the long distance commuter, and that's the commuter that has like 45 minutes plus of a drive. I have been in a situation where I have been both within walking distance and also like the long distance commuter. So I have a lot of experience when it comes to commuting. I feel like I've done it all. I've been to two universities, so I would consider myself pretty knowledgeable in the subject. But that's important to know, because depending on what kind of commuter you are, you may want to alter these hacks to best suit you and your experience. So without further ado, let's go ahead and get into the video, and we're gonna talk about the different hacks. Number one is having what I call a go bag. So a go bag is having, whether it's a little pouch, a massive bag, whatever, of personal hygiene things. Maybe if you wear makeup, maybe it's makeup. It could be makeup remover wipes, a brush. If you use dry shampoo, it could be dry shampoo, tissues. You can even get like a little disposable toothbrush that you use once and then you can throw it away. Things that you know that you need to kind of refresh yourself, or it could be deodorant, things like that. Think of toiletries or anything else that you use. I personally recommend this because even if you are within walking distance, sometimes it can be really annoying to walk a little further than what normal people have to walk to a dorm to refresh yourself, because when it's hot outside, you be sweating. You may not feel your best. You might need some perfume. Especially if you are a long distance commuter, this is even more important because you don't want to drive an hour back home to have things, maybe a change of clothes. Like, it's so crucial to have a go bag, to have maybe extra clothes in the trunk of your car, whatever that may be and whatever that looks like for you. I found that so beneficial because it made me more comfortable staying on campus longer. And like, I don't know, I get in my head a lot, and if I know that I'm prepared, I feel more secure and that I can do more things at the university that I'm at. So I think it's very important to have a go bag. And something that you may want to consider is bringing things for a sleepover. Not necessarily the full nine yards, but sometimes I would have situations come up where people were like, oh, do you want to spend the night? And it was last minute, and you don't necessarily want to drive all the way home if you live further away. If you live closer, maybe that's a different situation. Maybe not bring the sleepover stuff. But if you do live far away, that might be something that you want to have on hand because you're prepared and it makes things so much easier. And like, yeah, let's do it. And you don't even have to leave campus. Next, I said strategic communicating and planning. And this is where your planner in college will come in handy. Whether you're a commuter student or not, get a planner. Trust me on that. This is my planner. I have it right here. I think I got it from Walmart. But when it comes to this hack, it's very basic, and I understand that, but you have to think about it. If you're driving, you have to plan ahead. So if you're not good at planning your days or your weeks or whatever, you need to discipline yourself in that respect, because there's different school events going on. Like, there may be pep rallies, there may be some student activity event happening, you may want to go to the library, and you need to plan those things ahead because you may need to bring certain books, a certain change of clothes. If your friends want to do something and it requires different clothing attire, you want to be in the know and not feel like you're just super unprepared and like that kind of stuff. So it's very important that you really hone in on your communicating skills with your friends and what they might want to do, and whether you want to go to the library, you want to go off campus, you want to go downtown, whatever, and make sure you factor that into your day and how you're going to work around it and how you are going to make the day work for you, not having everything you need on campus. And that brings me into number three. My number three hack is something that may sound redundant. If you've watched any commuting to college videos, people say get involved, and that is so true. Honestly, when I commuted at my first university, if I was not involved in Greek life, it would literally feel like high school. If you do not get involved in the campus that you commute to, it will feel like high school, I promise you. So you can, again, join Greek life, go to student activities events or any other events that your university will put on, work studies, clubs, leadership programs, community service. My school at Liberty University, go Flames, we have this thing called CSER where we have to do 20 hours each semester of community service. So I 10 out of 10 recommend getting involved. It really helps you build a relationship with the school that you go to, and you feel like, this is my community. Like, these are my people, and this is where I'm at most of my time. Getting involved is everything. What you put into your college experience will be what you get out. So get involved, ladies and gentlemen. All right, number four, I said get a decent meal plan. You need to make sure that you have some kind of meal plan, whether you go to a public college, a private college, whatever it is. I know at my university, the way that a lot of people hang out is they get food together, and a lot of residential students, they will eat at the dining hall. And if you're not a residential student and you don't have a meal plan, you're gonna feel left out and you're gonna feel excluded. Yes, sometimes people may swipe you in or use a guest pass, however your school may do it, but I recommend getting a meal plan because you get to hang out with your friends, you get to build connections, you get to feel like you're a part of the campus, like you're doing what people who live in dorms do. And you're gonna need to eat on campus. You don't have to get the super expensive plan. I don't recommend it. Most times your school will offer a wide variety of meal plans for commuter students. So look at those, try and weigh the best options for you. I like to go with the intermediate one. The one in the middle seems to work just fine and is the best. And that's what I'm going to be doing next semester commuting. So get a meal plan. I promise you will benefit from it in some way, shape, or form. And the last hack, tip, whatever you want to call it, is make sure that you are befriending people who live in dorms. And yes, that's so obvious, but listen, when I was commuting, I had a bunch of friends who did live in dorms, and honestly, this is going to be something that comes natural, but you get to go into their dorms, you get to see how they live their life, you get to hang out with them maybe in their common area, in the community area, I know every university has a different term for it, or their literal bedroom. And that makes you feel like you kind of are living the dorm life. Even if you do live on campus, it's cool getting to see other people's rooms and how they decorate it. And you know, I love that so much. But yes, make sure you're friends with people who live on campus, because even if you've never lived on campus before and you're starting to commute straight off the boat, you know what I mean? It's nice because you're gonna get a different perspective on how people who live on campus approach their college experience and their college life. And especially having RAs, they definitely keep you in the know on everything that's going on with their school. Maybe certain important messages, announcements, like anything like that, that commuter students aren't necessarily in tune to. And like, you can have sleepovers with them depending on what college you go to. Like, if you have strict dorm rules, maybe not. You get to spend the night, you get to experience the dorm life without having to actually live in a dorm and pay that amount of money. Honestly, commuting isn't bad. Commuting is a very beneficial thing, especially if you want to save your coin. Commuting is not the worst thing in the world. It can be scary maybe at first because it's very unknown and new, but if you're thinking about commuting, I recommend it. I think that it is a good avenue to go down, and like I mentioned before, you're gonna probably end up commuting later in your college experience because that's just the way the cookie crumbles. That's how most people do it. But yeah, so hopefully this video could be helpful or beneficial to you in some way, shape, or form. If you like this video, make sure to give it a thumbs up and subscribe. I am posting a lot of back to school and college videos since it is the summertime and we're going back to school. It's going to be here before we know it. So if you have any questions or if you have certain video requests, definitely leave me a comment, let me know. And you can also turn on the bell notification to be notified every time I upload a brand new video. And the only thing left to say, ladies and gentlemen, my beautiful friends, is may the Lord bless you, may he keep you, may he make his radiant, glorious face shine upon you. I love you, Jesus loves you, you are valued, you are supposed to be here for a reason. Never forget that. I will see you in the next video. Bye.